against each other. Just hours ago, you did that. How are we to be blamed when we are always, almost always, at the butt end of justice? So that is why, in respect of serious crimes that have been committed in this country, that is why, in respect of international crimes that have been committed in this country, we have asked for international involvement, international inquiry, international judicial processes. How can you deny that? How can you say no when we can lay bare before you, not only we, you yourself did that a little while ago. You laid before the entire world the depths to which your judicial system had sunk. You were, you know, so vociferous. You thought you were accusing the other side, but you were in fact accusing the judiciary. And as I said, justifiably so. Take some recent examples, and I want to pick one example of a colleague of mine, Hijaz Hizbullah, a brilliant lawyer. Honorable Minister of Justice knows that very well. A brilliant young lawyer denied justice for 8 months. What are you doing for 8 months? If you had evidence that he was involved in anything at all, you could have charged him with that. What are you doing for 8 months? All kinds of false allegations were made against him. When his house was searched and he was arrested, Honorable Minister, they took away two of his case briefs. Not even in a court of law can questions be asked with regard to communication between client and attorney, and you know that very well. There are only two instances of privilege, one husband-wife and the other is attorney-client privilege. That's how sacrosanct communication between a lawyer and his client is. But they took even his client's files. Can't he have clients? Can't he handle cases for people who are later found to have committed other crimes? Is a lawyer to be blamed? All right, even if you did that, in those files, if you found anything, you could have brought that to light. You could have produced him before court. Nothing. Nothing to date. All kinds of spurious allegations are being made. Something about a school, that he was involved in some school. Now that school is still functioning. Nobody else has been arrested in respect of that school. That school is functioning. Everybody is happily running that school. But he is detained for involvement in that school. I mean, funny state of affairs. Funny ministry. He was said to have got assistance from Qatar Charity. No, Qatar Charity is still running. He's still involved. State is beneficiary as well. No, so what is wrong with Qatar Charity? If you can have it, you can still use it. You accuse him of being involved with Qatar Charity. There is not an iota of it. I have not spoken about Hijaz Hizbullah until today. For good reason. If there was something against him and there were investigations, let the investigators be free to find evidence against him. But after 8 months, his wife just gave birth to a child. He hasn't been able to even see his wife. Access to lawyers have been denied. I know you will say it was given sketchily here and there, given with a police officer sitting there and writing down every word that is spoken. Is that, I mean, you are a trained lawyer, right? Is that access? I'm picking one case, one emblematic case, to show how many thousands more are suffering like this. I'm picking that case because he's a lawyer. If you treat a lawyer like that, how do we expect you to treat anybody else any better? a lawyer who is well known, a lawyer who is regarded as a brilliant advocate in our courts, is being treated like this. Any other minister wouldn't want to don the hat of Minister of Justice at a time like this. They would resign and go home. That is why I said you must be feeling like the minister in Afghanistan of ports and shipping. That's the kind of state this country is in with regard to justice. Take the independent commissions. Those commissions are supposed to be independent.